Street artist Gabe 88, who declines to say his real name, has been painting for more than 25 years.
Graffiti saved my life.
A life full of art that saved him from a life full of crime.
I keep doing it because it gets me away from the everyday issues in life, and it's my kind of therapy.
But for more than a decade, it was something the city didn't allow him to do. Then the law was redrafted. City planner Tanner Blackman says the new law has quite a few restrictions many artists are unaware of.
I think that there's been, you know, some murals kind of going up recently where folks just think, hey, murals are legal again, and not sort of, you know, following the appropriate process.
The legal process includes the artist holding a meeting with the community to discuss their artwork, bringing a drawing of what they want to paint, and paying a $60 registration fee. But some homeowners feel that these requirements won't be enough.
There is absolutely nothing in the ordinance that says that that artist has to listen or take the advice or comments or criticism or suggestion of the community.
The city also has limited say in what is painted. Brody is upset about some questionable art in her neighborhood.
A couple blocks from my house, there is a mural of a dog urinating across a wall, and it goes all the way into a urinal, and the urinal overflows. The pee is attractive, it's kind of a collage, but no, I don't like it.
You kind of have to take a little bit of the good with the bad in terms of accepting different perspectives and art you may not like.
Due to lack of enforcement of the previous ban, murals have continued to thrive in LA. There are an estimated 3,000 undocumented murals.
I don't think it's going to make a big difference because the people that do graffiti art are still out there painting. It's all legal jargon.
But Gabe 88 doesn't have to worry about the legal jargon. His murals will now be grandfathered into the new law. Elisa Hernandez, ATVN.